क्वेश्चन नंबर वन, हैंड टूल्स लाइक रेंचेस, स्पैनर एंड हैमर आर मेड बाय द प्रोसेस ऑफ मशीनिंग, कैस्टिंग, जॉइनिंग एंड फॉर्मिंग। एंड द ऑप्शन इज फॉर्मिंग। रेंचेस, स्पैनर एंड हैमर आर मेड बाय द प्रोसेस कॉल्ड फॉर्मिंग, मेटल फॉर्मिंग प्रोसेस। क्वेश्चन नंबर टू, मिनिमम टेम्परेचर एट विच न्यू ग्रेन्स आर फॉर्म्ड इन मेटल इज कॉल्ड रिक्रिस्टलाइजेशन टेम्परेचर, इटेक्टाइट टेम्परेचर, पेरिटेक्टिक टेम्परेचर, इटेक्टिक टेम्परेचर। एंड ऑप्शन इज ए, रिक्रिस्टलाइजेशन टेम्परेचर। द रिक्रिस्टलाइजेशन टेम्परेचर फॉर स्टील इज 723 डिग्री सेल्सियस। इफ द मेटल इज परफॉर्म्ड अबव रिक्रिस्टलाइजेशन टेम्परेचर इट इज कॉल्ड हॉट वर्किंग, इफ इट इज परफॉर्म्ड बिलो रिक्रिस्टलाइजेशन टेम्परेचर इट इज कॉल्ड कोल्ड वर्किंग। सो मिनिमम टेम्परेचर इज कॉल्ड एज रिक्रिस्टलाइजेशन टेम्परेचर। मेटल फॉर्मिंग प्रोसेस आर जनरली दे आर रोलिंग इज अ मेटल फॉर्मिंग प्रोसेस, फोर्जिंग इज अ मेटल फॉर्मिंग प्रोसेस, एक्सट्रूशन, डीप ड्राइंग, वायर ड्राइंग, पियर्सिंग आर द मेटल फॉर्मिंग प्रोसेसेस। मेटल फॉर्मिंग प्रोसेसेस आर मेनली क्लासिफाइड इनटू हॉट वर्किंग एंड कोल्ड वर्किंग। इन हॉट वर्किंग इट इज परफॉर्म्ड, मेटल इज हीटेड अबव द रिक्रिस्टलाइजेशन टेम्परेचर एंड इट इज वर्क्ड। एंड एट एलिवेटेड टेम्परेचर्स मेटल्स बिकम वीकन एंड इट बिकम मोर डक्टाइल and this is used for working of the metals. Some metals have low recrystallization temperature, they can be cold work, there is no need of heating that materials. Third question, hot rolling of mild steel is carried out at recrystallization temperature between 100 degree celsius to 150 degree celsius below recrystallization temperature, above recrystallization temperature. For mild steel it is carried above the recrystallization temperature. For metals like lead and other some other low melting point metals, it can be performed below recrystallization temperature. For steel, it is performed above the recrystallization temperature. So option D is correct. The increase in hardness due to cold working is called as, options are age hardening, cold hardening, process hardening, work hardening. The increase in hardness due to cold working is called as work hardening. So option D is correct. Then question number 5, in metals subjected to cold working, strain hardening effect is due to, that is, it is also called as work hardening. Work hardening effect is due to, there are different mechanisms, slip mechanism, twinning mechanism, dislocation mechanism, fracture mechanism. It is due to slip mechanism. When steel undergoes a cold working process, it becomes progressively harder. Okay, options are softer, harder, ductile, malleable. So it become harder. When it cold working process, after it will become work hardened, it is called as work hardening. So it will become harder, it will lose its ductility. Okay, after cold working it will lose its ductility. In the metal forming process, the stress is encountered are options greater than yield strength but less than the ultimate strength, less than the yield strength of the material, greater than the ultimate strength of the material, less than the elastic limit. So it is the metal forming processes are mainly carried out for ductile materials. So the stresses encountered are greater than the yield strength but less than the ultimate strength. If it goes beyond the ultimate strength, the material will fail. So it is performed below the ultimate strength, but it is greater than the yield strength, for because it has to be formed, so the forming action have to be created. So it is greater than the yield strength but it is less than the ultimate strength. So option A is correct. In a rolling process, the state of stress the metal undergoing deformation is pure compression. Okay, in the rolling process it is under pure compression. So option A is correct. And in the rolling process, the material is fed in between two rollers. Okay, two rollers, and the material become, the thickness of the material is reduced after while it coming out of the roller. Okay, deformation process or thickness is reduced by compressive forces exerted by two opposing rolls. Okay, this is a workpiece and this is a final. It will go, when it goes out, its diameter is reduced, its thickness is reduced. It is a two high rolling mill. First one is two high rolling mill, so three high rolling mill and four high rolling mill, and it's a cluster rolling mill. It is a tandem rolling mill. So it is a bloom. When it is from the bloom, it is made into I section. It can be made into rails. From the slab, it can be made into plates, sheets and coils. From the billet, it is made into bars and rods. A steel wheel of 600 mm diameter rolls on a horizontal steel rail, carries a load of 500 newton. The coefficient of rolling resistance is 0.3 mm. The force in Newton necessary to roll the wheel is, the formula is F equal to mu into Rn. Okay, friction force F equal to mu into Rn. Mu is coefficient of friction 0.3 and load is 500 Newton. 0.3 into 500, 150 Newton. So option D is correct, 150 Newton. In a rolling process, the maximum possible drift is the difference between initial thickness and final thickness of the metal sheet. This is called as drift. Mainly depends upon which pair of the parameters. It depends on the parameters as strain, strength of the work material, roll diameter, roll velocity, coefficient of friction between the roll and the work. It depends upon the roll diameter and the coefficient of friction between the roll and the work. It does not depend upon the strain or strength of the work material, or it does not depend upon the roll velocity. It depends upon the only roll diameter and coefficient of friction. Okay, this drift is initial diameter minus initial thickness minus final thickness is called as a drift. In a rolling process, the state of stress of the material undergoing deformation is compression and shear. So the material undergoes, okay, compressive load is given, but material undergoes compression and shear. Okay, compression and shear stress. Okay, option C is correct. In a rolling operation, using rolls of diameter 500 mm with 25 mm thick plate can be almost reduced to 20 mm in one pass. The coefficient of friction between the roll and the plate is then draft equal to T naught minus T, final thickness minus initial thickness, 25 minus 20. So this is draft 5 mm equal to mu square into R. Okay. So mu square into R equal to 250 mm, diameter is 500 mm, so radius is 250 mm. So 5 divided by 250 is 1 by 50, mu equal to 0.1414. So option C is correct. Consider the following statements in respect of thread rolling. Okay, thread rolling is mainly, it is a main process used for making, thread rolling is a main process for used for making bolt and nut. Okay, bolt and nuts can be made by this thread rolling process. Okay, in all the bolt and nuts are made by this thread rolling process. It is a cold working, cold rolling process. It is not a hot working process. It is a cold rolling process. So all the, it is a bulk deformation process. There are two dies. Okay, there are cylindrical parts. Initially a cylindrical part is made and it is rolled between two dies. So a cylindrical part, initially a cylindrical part is a starting blank. It is a fixed die and it is a moving die, and it is pressed between the two dies. Okay, in between the fixed die and moving die, this is a starting of cycle and end of cycle, and finally the threads are formed on the surface of the blank. Okay, so this is called as thread rolling process. All the thread screws are made by this thread rolling process. It is performed by cold working in thread rolling machines. It is a mass production. All the bolt manufacturing factories, Sundaram Fasteners and all, are using this thread rolling process. So thread cutting process, in lathe you can make thread cutting. It is a very time consuming process, but thread rolling process is a higher production. It has higher production rates, better material utilization. Thread rolling process, and stronger threads can be made with this thread rolling process. Okay, come to the question. Consider the following statements in respect of thread rolling. Thread rolling results in lot of material saving. So this is correct. Thread rolling is generally used for internal threads. It's not correct. The cold working action of thread rolling produces a thread with improved tensile, shear and fatigue properties. Properties are also improved in using this cold working process. Okay, it will become a harder thread can be obtained, because it is a cold working results in harder working process. So it will produce a high strength can be obtained using this thread rolling process. So option C is correct. So 1 and 3 are correct, 2 is wrong. It is not used for internal threads. Next, thread rolling is restricted to ductile materials. It cannot be applicable for, it is restricted to ductile materials, not for other materials. So option B is correct. Thread rolling comes under cold machining, cold forging, cold rolling, cold extrusion. It comes under cold rolling. So 15C is correct. Consider the following statements about forgings. Next topic, forgings. Forging is involves plastic deformation of material between two dies to achieve the desired configuration. And there are two types of forging: open die forging and closed die forging. So it is a metal working process. In prehistoric days, it was used, and metallic tools were made by heating and hammering. Okay, in open die forging, metal is compressed by repeated blows by mechanical hammer, and shape is manipulated manually. Okay, in the cold working process, and that is for a hexagonal bolt is made by this open die forging process. The shape is manipulated manually, but in the closed die forging, there is no wastage, and the exact shape can be obtained upon closing, and exact shape can be obtained. In closed die forging, desired configuration is obtained by squeezing the workpiece between the two shaped and closed dies. So match the following: draft forging, repeated hammer blows. The material is subjected to repeated hammer blows in draft forging. And press forging. In press forging, metal is gripped in dies and pressure is applied on the heated end. It is called press forging. And upset forging, squeezing action is performed in upset forging. And roll forging, metal is placed between rollers and pushed. Roll forging. Okay, these are all the types of forging. The two main types of open die forging. This is open die forging. There is no closed end. The material workpiece is not closed. The process most commonly used for the forging of bolt heads of hexagonal shape is open die upset forging. Okay, open die, not progressive forging. Open die upset forging is used for making hexagonal shape. Okay, open die upset forging is used for making hexagonal bolt. Closed die forging. This is a closed die forging process. In draft forging, forging is done by dropping workpiece at high velocity, the hammer at high velocity, the die with hammer at high velocity, the weight on hammer to produce a requisite impact. The die with hammer at high velocity. So option C is correct. Die with hammer at high velocity. So this is a drop hammer. And the hammer carries a die, and it is forced. It makes a impact on the workpiece. It is a drop hammer. The process of removing burrs or flash from a forge component in drop forging is option swaging, perforating, trimming, petling. The option is trimming. The process of removing burrs or flash from the forge component is called as trimming. Option C is correct. Forging cameras, drop cameras. There are two types: gravity drop cameras. So it is impact energy from falling weight of a heavy ram. Power drop hammers accelerate the ram by pressurized air or steam. So these are the two types of drop hammers: gravity drop hammers, power drop hammers. Disadvantage: impact energy transmitted through anvil into the floor of the building. It's a main disadvantage of drop hammers. Commonly used forging is impression die forging. In hammer forging, the hammer does not consist of falling weight, anvil, die, lifting mechanism for the ram. So in hammer forging, it will not consist of die. So in drop forging, it consists of die, but it will not consist of the die. So option C is correct. In forging, a connecting rod from the bar stock, the operations are used. Edging. Okay, the correct sequence is EBFT. Okay, EBFT, edging, blocking, finishing and trimming. Trimming is a final operation. First edge have to be prepared, then blocking, then finishing, trimming. EBFT, connecting rod is the following processes are used. EBFT, edging, blocking, finishing and trimming. Okay, 4132. 4132, option D is correct. The ductility of a material with work hardening decreases. Okay. Because of work hardening, cold working, hardness increases. As hardness increases, ductility decreases. So option B is correct. Okay. In the forging operation, fullering is done to draw out the metal. Okay, upsetting and fullering are the two different operations. Fullering is the draw out the material, but upsetting increases the diameter. Okay, increases the diameter, upsetting increases the diameter, but fullering decreases the diameter.